the fourth row of our layout is again very similar to the second one. We have a tab widget with a button below it, and then we have to set up the widgets for the different tabs. So first thing is to take a tab widget under containers and drag it over, drop it onto the group box for add features. And then I'm going to change the layout of that group box to use a vertical layout. And I'm going to add a third page to that tab by doing a right click on top of it and using insert page. And now I'm going to give the tabs the right names in the property editor. Again, we have to scroll down to the green area, and there under current tab text, we change the titles. The first one should be called shapefile. The second one should be called layer. And the third one should be called CSV. And you have to make sure that you rename the entire tab widget as shown in the graphic, as in the figure, in the lesson materials, and also the individual tabs. So these entries here in the hierarchy need to be renamed. And then we can add the horizontal layout for the single button here. So that's something you have seen before now. I'm going to drag the horizontal layout, drop it on below the tab widget. And then we're going to add a push button to that horizontal layout. And a horizontal spacer so that the button is pushed all the way to the left. And the button, the title of the button, double-clicking it again and changing it to add. Okay, at this point, we just have to create the content for the different tabs, starting with the shapefile. Like the tabs above for the services, all these are using grid layouts to arrange the items, starting with the button that is for creating a new shapefile. So I'm dropping a push button into the shapefile tab widget, and then I'm going to do a right-click and change the layout to grid. And the title of the button should be changed to create new shapefile. And three dots, because this one is going to open a dialog which is indicated by the three dots. Then we have two labels below it. I'm going to add the first label and changing it to say add to shapefile. And then the second label below it. This one says field to store name. And then for the second row, we need a line edit widget for entering the name of a shapefile. So I'm dropping it here with the vertical blue bar on the right. For the third row, we need a combo box widget, so one which allows the user to pick between a small number of choices. Going to place there, it will be a horizontal layout. And then we're going to add the combo box to that horizontal layout. And we add the horizontal spacer so that the effect of that is that just the combo box again is not expanded all the way, but just as much as needed to display the items in it. And then the last thing missing is this tool button we have here that is going to open the file dialog for picking a shapefile. So we take a tool button under buttons and dropping it in the second row to the right of the line edit widget, like this. And then we have set up everything for this shapefile tab. And we can move on to the layer tab. Layer looks somewhat similar. We can start by adding the two labels. One will be called big layer, and the second one will be called field to store name. We're setting the layout of this tab to use a grid. And then we actually have two combo boxes here for both rows. So I'm dragging a combo box and place it to the right of the pick layer label, and another combo box to the right of the field to store store name label. And then we have another tool button for refreshing the list of layers. So that tool button I will drag over and drop to the right of the first combo box. And finally, so that all of this does not take more space than needed, we're going to place a horizontal spacer as a kind of the fourth column. And then everything will be pushed over to the left as much as possible. So that's it for the layer tab, and we can move on to the CSV tab. And that one is really simple now. Just has the grid with a single row. So could also use a horizontal layout for that. So I'm going to start with the label. Call that label add to file. Now I'm going to do right-click layout horizontally. And then I'm going to drop the line edit for entering the name of the CSV file to the right of the label. And finally, another tool button for opening a file dialog to the right of the line edit widget, like this. So, and now I'm saving everything. So basically we have the GUI for our main window done. There's just a little thing to do for this exit tool button we have at the top. And for this one, we have to set up an action so that we can directly say inside Qt Designer that this tool button here at the top should basically close the application. The action editor can be found here at the bottom right. And I just click this button, the first button at the top, which is for creating a new action. And then I'm filling out the dialog. The text for that action should be exit. The object name, action exit, that can remain like it is. And well, we can enter a tooltip exit program for it. And that's basically all we're going to do here. We're going to pick an icon for this later on from our code using the standard set of icons coming with Qt. So I'm pressing OK, and now we have this action in our list of actions here. And I can actually take the action and drag it and drop it on top of our toolbar that we have on top of the main window. And we now see that we have the action showing up there as exit, and we will replace that text later with the icon, as I said. So far, we have not said what the action should do. So I'm going to change to the signal and slot editor now by clicking on the tab below the action editor window. And I'm now going to add an entry there by clicking on the plus symbol. And for sender, I'm picking the action exit that we just created. Then I'm picking the signal triggered, so meaning whenever action exit is triggered, for instance, by clicking on the exit button in the toolbar, the signal should be sent to, and now I'm picking our application. So I'm clicking the main window, I mean, and picking the close slot, so meaning when the signal is sent to the main window, its close method will be executed and the application will be closed. Now I'm saving the program. And let's look at the preview for a moment. So we see the elements are all there. The different tabs are showing up correctly. But obviously, we don't have much functionality, so not a lot is going to happen, except that we can use already the toolbar to close the application.